Well, luckily here we are dealing with some pretty easy weather compared to all that stuff in California.
Yeah, that, and now there's a snowstorm heading up into New York, New England area, Jason, but we're sitting pretty right here.
It is, not bad. A little bit of wind to deal with, and temperatures a little cooler today as planned. In fact, yesterday we had those 70s that popped back up just for a little brief spell, and our cool front rolling through overnight, and those winds gusting now out of the north, cooling us down a little bit. Most noticeably, Daytona Beach, Palm Coast, where we're in the low 50s right now. It's 60 in Orlando and 61 at the Melbourne International Airport. So Palm Coast, your sunset, 5:32. It's clear. It's windy early, but those winds will slowly taper down to a more manageable level through the evening, and we're going to be sinking into the 40s. So it's definitely a crisp night out there. In fact, a little patchy frost possible around Bellevue, Ocala, maybe 1 hour of a light freeze around Salt Springs, otherwise 43 in Ocoee, and we're up to 40 in Deltona tonight, and that's about it. So it's a chilly night out there, 47 at Merritt Island, a little warmer at Cocoa Beach. High temperatures tomorrow are going to be similar to today, with mid-60s most spots, a few low 60s, though, heading toward Palm Coast and Daytona Beach, 66 in Orlando. But the difference tomorrow will be the wind, northeast about 5 to 15. So without all the wind, it'll feel a little warmer to most of us. And if you're traveling around tomorrow, the continued conditions for favorable travel look great. In fact, we'll be in the upper 50s across North Florida, low 70s across the south. And if you're heading about on Christmas Day, we're going to be dealing with a chance for some rain, especially the panhandle. This is where you're going to start getting socked in with some very wet travel, maybe late around St. Augustine, and of course late night in Orlando as we're watching for the changes to take place. Let's take a look at Christmas Day then. We're going to be warming up ahead of our next storm system and front back to the west. This high is going to be hanging out to our east. We have a low coming in from the west. So in between, a south wind develops, but it doesn't look like a strong wind. And this front that just came through has knocked out all the moisture, and so it's going to be hard to return any moisture to work with overnight Saturday and into Sunday for those heavier showers and storms. Although a couple of those showers could produce very gusty winds as they roll by, it really looks like early Sunday morning at this point, the best chance for most of us to get some much-needed rain. By Sunday afternoon, I do expect the skies to slowly clear out. Will be very breezy and will be turning colder. In fact, by Sunday night, temperatures will be down toward the freezing mark north and west of I-4, getting close to freezing all the way down to Orlando by Tuesday morning. And again on Wednesday morning, we could be dealing with frost and freeze concerns. So another cold snap in the making. Enjoy Christmas Day as I expect a high near 73. I'll have much more coming up.